Day 6, 9:46 a.m. Most of the housemates are asleep. Yesterday, Jackie Stallone, Bridget's ex-mother-in-law, became the ninth housemate to enter the house. Yesterday, Bridget told Big Brother she wanted to leave. Jermaine is the only housemate awake. Last night, she started a mutiny amongst the housemates by refusing to take part in the royal court of Big Brother.
I'm not going to wash, just once.
Hello, Jermaine.
Good morning, Big Brother. You'll notice I'm not wearing my microphone. That's because I don't consider myself a housemate anymore. Do you understand me?
Can you elaborate for Big Brother?
I'm leaving. I've forgotten the drill, but I'm leaving.
Can you explain your feelings to Big Brother, Jermaine?
There are two things. One is that I've been a school teacher all my life, and I've had to deal with bullying. And the concerted bullying of John, even though John's behaviour was childish, he should not have been bullied the way he was over the Diet Cola. And the other thing is the psychological bullying of Bridget, or Brigitte, or whatever she calls herself. Now, the interesting thing about that is I named both those people to you as people I thought were vulnerable in various ways. And I just can't, I cannot do it. I cannot misrepresent myself as appearing to be part of that sort of setup. I mean, everybody knows I disapprove of reality television, but that was when it was just tacky. This is worse than tacky, and I refuse to be a part of it. And I don't want to have to explain it for hours on end. If you take my advice, which I dare say you don't consider that you need to, you will get me out of here fast.
Big Brother does appreciate that it can be difficult in the house. Are there any positive aspects you can take from your experience so far?
No, as far as I'm concerned, it was a mistake. I shouldn't have done it, and I don't like making mistakes, but the important thing when you have made a mistake is to register, don't you think? Also, I'm in a position of enormous responsibility here. The fridge would be small for a family of two or even one. We also have no food, and I'm being Jamie Oliver here. Well, get Jamie Oliver, you know?
Jermaine, the rules of the task state you only need to cook for the Queen.
Tell the Queen that. The Queen's decided that everybody must sit down at once. The Queen also, apart from peeing 14 times a day, which means you should send in large quantities of cranberry juice, actually eats 5 times a day. And she chooses to do it because she has taken herself very seriously as the Queen. She asks for it to be done in banquet style. I've told you, this is not negotiable. We are not talking about what would make Jermaine stay. Jermaine's not staying. Get it? I make decisions like other people have accidents. I can't undo it. It's done.
I forgot how to get out. The simplest thing is to hurt.
...10:22 a.m. It's been 30 minutes since Jermaine told Big Brother she wants to leave the house. Jeremy's in the shower. The other housemates are in the bedroom. As part of the royal court of Big Brother, Jackie was given the role of Queen Mother. This means she must be accompanied to the toilet by two courtiers. As Jackie was the first to bed, she doesn't yet know that the other housemates have given up on the task.
Just go to the bathroom.
Well, they have a light. They said that I'm not allowed to go to the bathroom alone.
We quit.
Go anywhere?
Yes.
No. Let me find it.
I mean, why are you taking a shower at this hour?
Why?
Who takes a shower at this hour?
Me, no, because I woke up, I couldn't sleep.
Who can sleep?
Did you sleep right there?
Hell no, my head hurts, everything hurts. I can't find a light. You're supposed to have a light?
No, they'll switch them off.
You didn't need a light in here. How are you going to get around it? I've got to make a run for the bed. You know, you could break your neck in here. No. And I didn't want to bother. I'm supposed to wake poor Bridget up to ask her to take me to the bathroom.
Let me just see if there's a light for you here.
Is there a light in here? Yes. There is a light. I'm going to take my earrings off. Oh, my God. And one of my head hurts. I went to bed with my earrings on.
Most of the housemates are still in bed. John and Jermaine are in the living area. John's telling Jermaine about his nicknames for his fella housemates.
Brigitte, I call them meringue, because if she was one, she'd eat herself. So it's, she's got this little white dollop of cream on the top of her head. It reminds me of a meringue. But she's an innocent child, like, you know, she's not calculating, she's not, you know, we're all frightened of her, but she's no reason to be at all. She's just childlike, self-centred, that's, well, she is, totally. But that is Brigitte.
It is like a child.
It is. She's totally childlike. She's like a meringue.
Jeremy's in the diary room talking to Big Brother.
How are you today?
I'm okay. Not quite sure what to do, though. I need to speak to somebody because, I don't like giving up on things, but I just think it's a bit rubbish. I just think it's a bit... It's not really what I thought would happen. I'm a bit pissed off. A little bit pissed off, anyway. When you brought Jackie in, Nat and I thought, that's just such a low blow. That just changed the whole balance of the thing. But, I don't know what to do. I just don't know what to do. And I'm not angry and I'm not upset. Well, I'm a little bit angry and a bit upset. That's a lie. I'm not angry and not upset. But I am actually having a really good time. I am actually really enjoying it. And I think there'd be more good times to be had. And this is what I was thinking about last night, that I would miss it in terms of... I would miss it. That's the funny thing already, yeah. So I suppose I am bonding with people. Maybe I'm denying myself. Because I was thinking, you know, they all make me laugh, and even Jermaine, what bloody stories that go on forever. But she's so, you know, you just have to respect her. But I don't trust you. Do some clever stuff. You know, I just don't know what's going to come next in terms of, you know, what you're going to bring Rachel in or something, you know, a performance or... something from my, you know, or from someone else's past that's just gonna make their life difficult and upset them.
Big Brother has taken on board what you have said,
right,
and doesn't want housemates to be upset.
Can I leave the diary room, please?
You may leave the diary room.
Thanks. I don't have my Mac on.
Look.
You look lovely.
I don't have one.
I know.
They're above you, be careful.
Oh, yeah, I'm
there. Oh, John!
Sorry.
Really, we need something to drink.
Well, you could try water.
I'm going to.
If you'd want to take your life in your hands. A bit of recycled sewage, a little bit of it. Christ, look at this mess, and there hasn't even been a meal.
We've got marmalade.
Got nothing.
See you later.
It's 11:15. Another perfectly serviceable day wasted.
Well, I've had two decent nights' sleep. Did you sleep at all last night, Jeremy?
I think I must have done.
No, I really worried, seriously, because anyone doesn't sleep, however young and fit they are, you can't do that for very much.
No, I know, yeah, I'm feeling it, I must admit. But
you've got to get proper air.
Yeah,
that's absolutely basic, fundamental.
That is true.
But if you don't sleep, that is.
I'm losing it! Oh.
What's wrong with you now?
I'm allergic to repetition that gets me down
listen,
after 5 days.
You are more like a gorg on a level now. Keep quiet.
Keep quiet, please.
Well, don't freeze me, for God's sake. Don't freeze me in stone. Of course you repeat yourself. In life we repeat ourselves daily, let alone when you're stuck in a place like this.
12:02 p.m. Most of the housemates are still asleep. Earlier today, Jeremy told Big Brother he wanted to leave the house. Jermaine has told Big Brother she's leaving, and Big Brother has returned her suitcase.
What's the time?
Mr. Wolf.
Mrs. Wolf.
Quitting time, Boyle, is all you need to know.
Well, some of us are morning people.
Well, we have to get up, do we? Where are you going?
I'm going home.
Get real.
I am real.
Why?
Why?
Were you fired?
Yes,
these
times. Yes, I was fired. What
oh,
about
don't.
That?
Well, she wasn't, was she?
Yes, of course she was.
Sorry, tell me.
Don't tell me that. I thought they'd do it in public.
They'd love to, I guess. No, they wouldn't, actually, in this case, are they?
Oh, thank you. Is she really leaving?
She's had enough. She wants to go home.
Oh, but I loved you so much. I'm going to miss you.
Oh, baby.
No, please stay. You have issues. Come on, I need you. I need the emotional support.
I have a problem with decisions. I make them fast, and when I make them, they stay made.
Are you? I think you're kidding.
I'm not kidding.
I thought that basically they have to fire you in public.
Listen, when do you go on the air?
But on the air, 24 hours.
Everyone's looking at us now.
Yeah. Yes, baby.
Like this?
Yes.
You spent a fortune to try to look good and put on your clothes and makeup. And here the world sees you looking like shit.
Yeah, no.
I can't believe it.
You see you looking like all sorts of
my whole life. I don't know why I bought anything with me.
I'm not laughing. Anyway, I think I thought it was funny.
I can't believe this one. You worked quite a bit harder than everyone else does.
Yeah,
still.
A lot harder.
I did not.
What did I do? I ain't done jack.
Don't make me cry. Oh. I'm just annoyed, Marcy, for making such a stupid mistake.
Oh, come on, it's not your fault.
It was a stupid mistake. I should never have done it. I'm not even surprised that it's like this, even though it is more disgusting than I thought. I just kind of is a rage and embarrassment.
Twelve:14 p.m. Jermaine is finishing her packing. As housemates failed to collect all of their shopping in their task on Saturday, Big Brother has supplied housemates with additional basic food supplies.
All they've not done is my dark coats, the bastards.
I mean,
you're joking. You're joking.
There's still that little one got you.
That baffle, no, that baffle goes on.
You got me on, have you?
All they've done is fuck me. That's all they've done.
That's playing apple, doesn't it?
That's all they've done.
Funny though.
Last night, Bridget told Big Brother that she wanted to leave the house.
Hello, Brigitte.
Hi.
What are your feelings? What are your thoughts?
It's not going to work. It's not the issue, it's not that Jackie's here that's... It's actually really freaking me out. I mean, it could be, but she's been okay. I mean, it's not really been bothering me. With Jackie, with Sylvester and that whole situation, it took years and years and years. It destroyed my family and everything. It's, by the fact she's in here, even if she's behaving well and she's changed and whatever, thinking about the whole thing, I don't think I can risk it. And it's not personal to her. I just know how the papers and everybody will treat the subject. It's like giving blood to a shark. Another thing is staying, being nominated out of the house and her being in here and how I'm going to have to deal with it. And I don't feel quite ready with that. But I repeat, my decision is not personal against you or Jackie. Not towards anyone, but it has to do with her, obviously. It has to do with her because they're gonna have a ball with the situation that her and myself were in here. I feel bad that I leave because Lisa's amazing. And Caprice too, you know, she's a sweetie. She's really a sweetheart and I feel bad for them.
Brigitte, Big Brother really doesn't want you to leave, and neither would your housemates.
You do understand I was having a good time in here, you know? And I'm just so... It's because Big Brother does not know what it means to... Eventually, when I step out of here, what it's going to be out there. And I know it's a very selfish sort of thing to do, because I'm supposed to obey in here. It's just... Let me go and talk to my friends in there. Okay?
One is the bullying of John, which I didn't, as a teacher, I cannot have children taught on television how you bully someone,
mm-hmm.
What that means.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And for the treatment of you, same.
Yeah, I understand.
Shemaine, come to the diary room.
I can see you in a winter coat. I'm not noticing.
Yeah,
oh, there it is. We're just a cook.
Do you want to talk now?
Yes, Big Brother, here I am.
Hello, Jermaine.
Thanks for getting me out of there.
Big Brother has made all the preparations for you to leave the Big Brother house.
Yeah?
Somebody will come and collect you now.
From here?
That is correct.
Oh. 2 years of relief, I think.
Thank you, Jermaine, and goodbye.
Bye-bye.
PM. It's been 33 minutes since Jermaine left the Big Brother house. All housemates are in the living area. Bridget, Lisa and Caprice are discussing comments that Jackie made last night concerning an American TV show that Bridget was in.
I shouldn't have even said anything, but you just... when you
We have honesty here, though, don't we, between us guys? We're not bitching, we're just trying to sort out facts from fiction. What does she say?
She was just making a comment about a TV show that you did in America.
About the one with Flavor Flav?
I don't know.
So it was a bitchy comment?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
It was a mean, and did you, okay, comment.
It's not for you to uphold her, you know, reprimand her on that. What did you say? Did you say anything? Just to get the rest of the story?
Well, she said it was a certain kind of show, and I don't know what kind of show it was, right. And I just said, what? Nah. Let me ask you a question,
mm-hmm.
and then it'll clear things up for me. Maybe it wasn't a bitchy comp, maybe it was mm-hmm. the truth, and if that's the case, then I don't care. I don't care what anyone
yeah.
does. You know
good.
What I mean? But she said that you did a show in America that was a porno.
That's ridiculous.
Right, listen to me. There is potentially an opportunity here to turn this situation to a positive.
Yeah, I said
which
that.
Is, yeah. after 20 fucking years, this bitch of a hellish mother-in-law yeah. gets a chance to go, you know what, Pachi? I owe you an apology. And you know, and you could go, right, you know what? I'm bigger than all that. You're right, you do, I'll take it. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah.
There is an opportunity here to make some peace here.
I would just not want to be... Oh, she starts a whole thing. Yeah.
But then we don't know she's going to start. She's no idea what the fuck's going on. Therefore, she needs us to help her through her day.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, she's very aware of the unity of this group that she's just walked into.
Mm-hmm.
So she needs to be behaving.
Yeah, it would just be nice if she starts this stuff, because I cannot.
But she's not. You know what? We're assuming stuff
that.
From 20 years ago.
Don't worry about it.
So there are positives to be gained. But you know what? The only way that can happen by you thinking, okay, I'll give her this go, I'll give her a chance, I'll see how it goes. And actually, if this is your domain, she's walked into it. So, step at a time and see how we get on today.
Okay.
Yeah?
Step at a time.
Okay.
And you know what? I'm watching that I'm watching that lady like a hawk, don't you know? As is she, as is, we've got our soldiers as well. Plus, hey,
John,
brilliant. All day long.
Hey.
Yeah. All week long. Perfect. Beautiful.
And here's, I'm going to make you breakfast. You want some?
Mm. Egg, bacon, sausage, and a bit of toast.
Porridge? Nothing?
Oh, no, thank you, sweetie.
Love you. Good.
Earlier, Big Brother gave the housemates some sparkling orange and lemon drinks with their basic rations. Big Brother calls Kenzie to the diary room to deliver some additional soft drinks for the group.
Betting? Odds on, it's the batteries. Any betting?
I'll bet it ain't, mate.
Oh, you bastard! What is it?
Hello, Kenzie.
Hello.
Kenzie, please find some Diet Cola on the chair. Additional items for your consumption.
Thank you, Big Brother.
That's what they want. Well, they want to ask her, but they were hoping it would happen.
Oh, man, John.
Oh, well done. You know what the swine offered me yesterday? They said, next week's Cokes. You know, next week when we order the Cokes. That's what they offered me. Isn't it pathetic? I'm easily bought. Bars of gold or dump champagne or this comes in. Suddenly I'm weak at the knees. I'm anybody. Oh, it's tremendous. No, I'll put it in the fridge. Yeah. Don't thank them. They've done that. They've returned stolen property. This is stolen property returned. They stole it.
They took the piss. They knew it, man. Right, careful on your thing, man. Your boy.
...1:42 p.m. The housemates are eating lunch in the living area. Earlier today, both Jeremy and Bridget talked to Big Brother about leaving.
Don't you want to sit at the table?
I'm too tired to move. I'm so comfortable on this stool, I've never sat on one in my life, so I might as well sit on it. Now, I know I'm going to be missed, but I'm going to bed.
Good for you. Yeah.
You're not missing anything out here. You stay in your
Listen,
pit.
I don't care if I stay asleep for 4 days. Once in a while, take my pulse to see if I'm alive. It's raining.
I feel really merciless moving so quickly into Jermaine's bed. It's still practically warm, but obviously I'm going to take that mess.
Yeah.
But I'm going to take. I'm going to wash the sheets and do a pillowcase for her on the thing.
Go straight
outside. I expect that's part of the deal.
Yeah.
I mean, we've got some food.
No, you have the right attitude.
Yeah.
Which
right
is
attitude,
sticking with
Jeremy.
It, and therefore I'm going to stay.
Yeah,
I'm going
to
support her.
You have the right attitude.
And now it's everything we can.
Yeah, back to normal.
Yeah. Except I'm not doing any of those chunks that make me ill. Or anything like that. I'm not
Should we just
that
get
door,
to those when we get to
Yeah, we don't need to worry about that.
I'm not closing that door.
John, don't worry
don't
about
worry
it.
About
Let's
that.
Just deal with that
Concentrate
when we get
on
to
the
it.
Here and now.
Concentrate now, yeah.
Exactly.
3:20 p.m. Earlier today, Jermaine left the Big Brother house. Jackie's in the private bedroom. The rest of the girls are in the hot tub. John's in the shower.
That's it, keep your elbows in as close to your body as you can.
The rest of the boys are exercising in the living area. Earlier today, Big Brother provided the housemates with two bottles of Diet Cola that John has stored in the alcohol fridge.
The baby locked his fucking cokes in. That would be fucking hilarious. Yeah. Imagine. Have you? Have you? The fucking padlock on. Give it here. Kenzie, fucking brilliant. No, just put one padlock on. We're going to chain it.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, let's go then, quick, before he sees. Don't let the girls see them. We're going to. How do you do it? No, it's all right, he's in the bathroom.
It's not coming.
He's in boggy.
The padlock's gone. Our cars are kerfuffle.
That's fucking brilliant. Nice work, Kins. Maybe
a big one. Let's put it round one more time so it looks like he's been done for off.
Yeah. Right, nice.
He knows it's not professional.
It doesn't matter. Look, as if he's going to think about that.
Yeah, as if he's going
to. It'd be so good if he went in on his own to complain. Didn't we can sneak in, undo it, come out, and he'll be like. And we'll be like, no, I never saw it locked. Brilliant. Right, come on, last lot.
Normal ones.
Dips, the whole lot. Yeah, just normal push-ups. All the boys, come on, eat. And go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
4:47 p.m. Jackie has just got up.
Do you ever use frosted makeup?
Yes. Where are you using it? Oh, let me see. No, maybe not.
I thought you'd been here the whole time.
The rest of the housemates are in the living area.
Is that locked?
Just having to confirm it's locked.
Yeah, it's locked.
It's not locked.
It is.
Are you sure?
Oh, tell me, seriously.
It's locked.
It's locked.
Go get him.
Why don't they? How can they do this?
I don't know.
Games they're playing.
Man. You know what? Someone probably just went in, bang, out of there without us. Everyone was doing their thing.
What on earth are they playing at?
Is it open yet?
No, they daren't open it because they know I'm
in there. No, they probably, yeah.
Oh, yeah. There we go.
Easy on him.
I'm going easy. Politeness gets the way.
Hello, John.
Yes, you've locked the fridge. Oh, my Diet Cokes are in there, please. So could the key be left here? Whatever else happens, could the key be left here? I can open the fridge for my Diet Cokes and not mess around, keep it locked and closed. If you want the Diet Cokes out of the fridge permanently, fine. All I do was keep them cold, so I'll keep them out of the fridge if you want to lock and unlock for various other things. But could you have the keys for it now, please, or as soon as possible?
Oh,
yeah,
it's so cruel.
Yeah,
that is like...
Oh, no, he was so happy.
I'm sorry,
man.
That is so cruel. That is so cruel. Who came up with that? Kenzie came up with that.
Don't tell him it was me. Tell him when we're pissed.
Yeah. When he comes out, when you give it to him.
Yeah. I'm a bit afraid to give it to him.
No, he'll see the funny side. This is our way of saying, you know...
Okay.
Chill out.
Big Brother, the fridge where the wines that are kept. I got the Diet Cokes. We won't talk about who won and there's. I don't crow. Don't you try and get revenge on me, by the way. Don't even think it. So, got the Diet Cokes, moved them outside to keep it cold. But then I thought, well, the fridge is open, so I go and put them in the fridge. You know, that fridge under the thing where the wines and the arcs are put. Go there now. It's locked. Somebody's gone and locked it.
John, Big Brother has not tampered with the fridge.
Oh, God.
Here we go. Ready?
Right, okay.
It's your fault. You've let me down here. One of you have locked it.
We were having a joke with you, John. Look, we've got your glass.
Fuck's sake. Oh, well.
Come on.
I don't be bloody stupid. It's not funny. I don't like practical jokes. I fought for this all the time. All the battles. It's not funny.
It is funny.
Practical jokes are not funny.
It's hilarious.
It is not funny. We've got enough troubles it is without winding ourselves up. Are you thick and stupid, all of you? They're winding us up the whole time. We're doing it to ourselves.
No, we're sorry.
Well, yeah, well, if you're sorry, you will never, ever do a practical joke on me again. Ever. Anybody else?
Don't point at me.
Any of you. All of you. All of you, I will. Don't ever do that again.
PM. Bridget's cooking dinner in the kitchen for the housemates.
A gorgeous smell.
Thank you, baby.
It looks lovely, right?
Isn't it?
Jackie has been awake for 14 minutes.
Do you like these chairs?
The best thing we have to look forward to is going to bed another day. What else do we have to look forward to?
How is your bed?
It's a water bed.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's full of lumps. I tell you, the worst situation finding a bathroom. There's no privacy.
Yeah, that's one thing. Yeah.
Well, the one thing I relish in my whole life is privacy.
Yeah, man.
Certain countries, this would be paradise. But to me, this is like living like a dog. I'd like to know what's going on in the world. Is England still on the map?
Are you bored already?
I am so bored. I hate to
tell
you.
Do you want to play cats?
No, I'm too bored to even get off this chair. Who do you think's going to come and replace the girl that left?
I don't think they're going to do it.
I hope they send in a clown, don't you?
She was really upset, wasn't she? Did you speak to her before she left?
I am, aren't you?
Yeah, no, I was up.
You know why? She was lovely, and I don't know why she left.
Yeah, I think it was the humiliation thing. She felt a bit humiliated.
She felt humiliated about what?
The whole everything.
Yeah. Doesn't she look at Big Brothers?
Big Brother.
One brother.
One, just Big Brother.
Have you known the George Orwell
novel, 1984? Yeah.
What?
You know the George Orwell novel, 1984? It's about Big Brother is watching you, the idea that in the...
Who came up with this concept?
Yeah,
true.
I'm not humiliated. I've never seen the show. I didn't even know what I was walking into. I was promised a mansion. I have crystal chandeliers. You know, the kind of stuff you're promised when you go to heaven? The angels will come out and everything will be gold and silver. I was promised that I would be entrusted with eight of the most brilliant people in England. We're going to put all of you together and see how you hold up. Well, I thought, that's a challenge.
Well, the only one there was Jermaine. She was the only outstanding person here. The rest of us are nothing.
Well, I never heard of her.
Cheers, bro.
No, she was.
I kind of consider myself
John,
a good one.
John, you'll compliment
me. Ridiculous. What? I consider myself
a different class.
To ignore it. Nothing.
Oh, she's clever, she's knowledgeable, everything.
Well, so what?
She is.
No, she is intelligent, but honestly, John, why are you putting us all down and yourself?
To compliment her.
We're all special. We all have our own.
You see what he does? He puts our dad to compliment her. Why didn't he just compliment her?
I know, exactly. You know, she has a point. Why don't you just compliment her instead of putting us all down and then complimenting her?
Compared to her intelligence is so much...
But don't compare anyone just because she's amazingly bright.
She is.
Exactly.
She is.
And that's it. Compared to her brightness.
That's it.
Perfect.
You're silly.
5:18 PM. All the housemates are sitting at the dining table eating a meal prepared by Bridget of mashed potato, meatballs, pasta peas and chickpeas.
Well, I think, honestly, somebody, they don't know the score. No fine meal goes without wine.
Well, that's what I was saying. It's the first one that has.
Do you want pasta?
Oh, no,
potatoes to save the pasta.
I've never had a meal in my life without some fine wine.
I had a little, just a little.
The last time I saw in the news, Britain was in for a big storm.
Well, it's been here.
It's been and gone.
No, that's the last thing. I mean, a major.
Yeah,
and let's see.
It's been and gone.
In one state, what state was it? The winds were like 150 miles an hour, and they're blowing people right off the street. people forming chain gangs to keep from blowing away. I forgot what state, what country. Should I tell them what my last words to my husband when I left? Well, the last I remember, I was in my hotel bed, and he was leaving for Dubai, and he kept saying goodbye and trying to kiss me. I kept waving. I was so exhausted, I kept saying, please, just bye-bye with my fingertips. So I'm sitting here. Now, what we should do as the Romans do, all stretch out on the floor and go to sleep for 3 hours. Are we allowed to discuss that? That's what the Romans do after a nice feast like this. We're sitting at a Roman table. We should all stretch out and take a nap.
Bridge, what you want to do with enough photos?
It's very comfy. What else is there here?
I really didn't expect to have this much today.
Is there a smaller Tupperware?
No,
this is for the girls. This is the boys' job, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah,
this is the boys' job.
5:48 p.m. Lisa, Caprice and Bez are in the bedroom. John, Kenzie, Jeremy and Bridget are discussing Jackie in the living area.
Anyway, she's not quite on the planet, is she, the dear? By the way, you talk about, you know, between you and I, about facelift and Botox and lips. How they have their lips done like that is disgusting. It is, oh, gross, isn't it? Absolutely, yeah. Great big thick lips full of what this estrogen or whatever the muck is and all that. Oh! Admittedly, she would be looking absolute harrowed if she hadn't had all this done, but she's hooked up and eyed out. Oh, great. She's the next worst thing to the bride of Wildenstein.
Jackie's in the dining room talking to Big Brother.
You want me to enhance the show, and I think basically, since you have such a great audience, you have to give us some material to work with to cheer us up so we get motivated intellectually and physically. Now, number one, we just had a divine dinner, but there's something missing. And what we should have with dinner every day would either be champagne's a very nice idea, or some lovely Chardonnay wine. And then, it's very nice, we don't have to read newspapers and TV and this, but how about sending in a lovely harpist, who you can gag her, she won't talk, and to play a nice song for us while we dine.
Jackie, Big Brother has noted your request. However, champagne, chardonnay, wine, and all alcohol is provided at Big Brother's discretion.
I understand it's at his discretion, but I'm giving you a legitimate reason why we should have it at our discretion. Everything's at their discretion. We understand that. But now at our discretion, we would like to have a glass of wine with our dinner. We had a great meal and some soft music just for dinner. Now, you can certainly pipe in a harpist. The harp music is very lovely. And this sort of inspires us and gives us something to talk about. And also, we're adding some culture to this place. There's no culture here. This place and that your public audience, who basically turns on the TV to be enhanced. They got a dull life at home. They don't have to look at 8 dull people. They said that I would be with 8 of the most brilliant people in England. I was hoping you'd have someone like Bill Gates here. They talk about, frankly, nothing. Actually, the cute little boy talks about nothing. No one's talking about anything.
Jackie, you were told before you left Los Angeles that Bridget would be in the house. How do you feel now that you're here?
I think she's lovely. I mean, I have nothing against her. She married my son. That's their problem. I didn't make so many great choices myself. It didn't work. It's like going to a bum movie. It's a mismatch. But the fact is, she's very lovely. She just cooked dinner today. And a very fine dinner. I couldn't do it. She said she's cooking another dinner tomorrow. She's been very kind to me. That isn't the issue. I am not sitting here to talk about Bridget. I'm sitting here to talk about enhancing my own life, which would consist of a bottle of wine for my lunch. I insist on a glass of wine with my dinner, and I don't care what the hell he sends at nighttime. That's not my issue. They ought to give us brandy so we sleep nice. I mean, that's the answer. Wouldn't hurt Big Brother to learn a little bit about culture. Okay.
Okay, thank you, Jackie.
You're welcome. Bye.
Bye-bye.
PM. Some of the housemates are asleep in the bedroom. The rest are on the sofas, talking about air travel.
Can I tell you, I love flying. I do.
Where do you go? It's different to the rest of us.
I used to. If I have to pay for my own ticket, yeah. I'm going economy. I am not going to pay those prices. Okay, maybe I get upgraded a few times, but there's no way. It's ridiculous, the kind of money.
What is wrong with you? What is money?
There's nothing.
No, you're right.
Right, when was the last time you went in the cattle truck?
I go there all the time, mate.
Yeah, but you're skint like me, so we're skint people. But when was the last time you went cattle truck?
Yeah, I can't remember.
So you aren't regular on cattle truck?
No, I'm not regular because I have my clients paying for me to fly around everywhere.
But say, in the last year, how many times roughly have you been cattle truck? The last year, say. Hundreds of flights you must have done. Why, God, have you put yourself in the hell of the cattle truck when you can avoid it?
I know, but I just think very different. You know, I'm very young and I still haven't had my kids and my family and I don't know who I'm going to marry. You know, he may not have a pot to piss in, so I have to support the family.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So you just have to start thinking responsibly.
I think responsibly, but there's a limit to it.
So a few times I go in the back, who cares? Do you know what I mean? Who cares?
It's good for you.
Yeah, who cares?
Well, I must say, I have in my time, I hate to admit this, but you won't believe this, it is too awful to admit. But going over to the States, I've gone club class and put the booby into the cattle truck.
I know. You are so disgusting, John. I can't believe you did that, and I can't believe you just admitted it. Are you crazy?
I know.
And she did it?
Well, yes.
I would have divorced you. I would have never married you.
No, I'm not too proud of that, honestly.
I can't. That is
disgusting. No, the reason is... Hear the case for an offence.
No, there is no case. That's disgusting.
I love that. And I put the booby in the kettle.
No.
Like a piece of lead.
No.
I can't believe you did that.
No, hear the case for the offence.
John, it's just wrong. Right. Did you at least trade off halfway through the trip?
What do we mean?
Gentlemen, go back and say, "Booby, I love you so much." Why don't you go?
That's exactly what you should do. Okay, I understand you have to go club class around, but that one journey at the beginning with the booby, she should go in club, you should go
100%.
Economy, and then as a gentleman,
trade off halfway through.
An Englishman.
You are such a schmuck. I can't believe you did that. That's horrible.
Well, it is a suggestion.
Oh, no, don't call him a schmuck.
No. Well, what is it?
Shit.
Let me ask you this question, right? And give me an honest answer. Don't say where it was. What is the most you've ever been paid for a single day's work?
For one of my jobs was $500,000.
God! Right! God, $500,000, and then you're still traveling cattle truck? Can you believe it?
For one day!
I'm telling you, I am so fortunate.
I'm so fortunate.
But I think it's crazy too.
But if they pay to pay it, you just take it, dear.
Fuck no. Absolutely.
If there are mugs there, you just go out and take it.
I'd be there like a shark.
So would I. But I would balk at $500,000 for 10 days. I don't think it's quite enough. In 10 days work off.
Come on, that's only $50,000 a day.
I know. You start to think how mean.
Even I don't get out of bed for that.
You start thinking how mean can some of these employers be? They want to use your name and use this, that, and the other, and they're only paying $50,000 a day. I think, quite frankly, no. My services are not available. I would tell them. Oh, God, pray.
PM. John, Caprice, Bez and Jeremy are in the seating area, talking about their new housemate, Jackie.
She's not been around much, though, is she, really?
Oh, she's an old dear, for God. Look after her.
I didn't say I wasn't going to look after her. I said she hasn't been around much.
No, but she's a batty old dear, and look at her, stuck here. Poor girl, she's doing really well to hang in there.
Scared the shit out of me this morning when I was in the shower. Yeah. You lot were still
listen,
asleep.
Listen to this.
I was in the shower. She walks in.
And screams.
Fucking screams. I turn around and see her screaming first thing in the morning. I scream back. And then her bright red pyjamas with all that fucking everything all over the place, hair like a banshee. I'm having a shower, she has this, I turn around, it's just like, I was like, Jesus, I was terrified.
Oh, God.
Oh, that is funny.
What time was that? This morning?
No, I got up, whatever time I got up, about 9 or something.
A lot of drama, I like a bit of drama, love.
Thank God for that.
Boy, we don't lack in that department here.
If you can't live without, there's more on E4 right about now. For all the latest news from the Big Brother house, just hit the website, channel4.com/Big Brother. Next tonight, the perfect lesson in child discipline, Wicked Desperate Housewives.